So there are fewer cars on the road these days, obviously, but apparently the ones out there are going really fast. And as Denver 7's Sloan Dickey reports, police are busier than ever.
We're still patrolling, and my unit's sitting down here right now on C-470, and he's been busy all day.
Police officers with the responsibility of enforcing new social distancing measures are now dealing with one more.
We wrote 440 tickets in March, and of those, only about 20 of them were under 20 miles an hour over the limit.
Speeders taking advantage of open roads during social distancing are pushing triple digits on highways and side roads. Law enforcement taking to social media to share the jaw-dropping numbers.
A little more extreme than the stuff we've been experiencing in the past. Our accidents up on 285 are a lot more severe than they have been in the past.
And it's not just interstates and state highways seeing this problem. In Denver, traffic enforcement officials say it's bad in the city, too.
On 56th Avenue in North Denver, and that's a 45-mile-an-hour zone. We had some that were over 75 at that zone. So, yeah, we see people that are definitely taking advantage of the situation.
As enforcement officers across the state deal with an increase in speeding on the roadways, they say the higher the numbers, the higher the penalty.
If you're up into those high levels, so what we've been talking about is 25, 30 or more, first of all, we can attach a reckless driving ticket onto that, along with the fine.
After weeks of pulling over heavy speeders taking advantage of open roads, they're all pretty much saying the same thing.
Just because we have fewer people on the road, it doesn't make it a racetrack.
Lower those speeds to save lives and prevent injuries from happening.
Slow down. Help us help you.
Slow down. Or don't go 139 in a 65. I'm Sloan Dickey reporting for Denver 7.